in the CECAFA region. I don't understand why they just seem to be so disjointed, and they just don't have the cutting edge that we expect from the side of their caliber.
Yuri with the throw-in on the near side. Approaching 30 minutes of play. A second goal more than welcome here for the side from Uganda. Also brings a fair bit of experience into this tournament. Early ball. Good looking ball then. Certainly had to be dealt with defensively in the end. The great quality in that delivery sees URA getting themselves a corner.
What is surprising me most is that URA doesn't have as tall strikers, but they are, you know, giving a lot of trouble to Simba in the aerial department. I don't understand why Simba just seems to be finding it difficult coping with that.
Now, ball in towards the far post. Sees Kaseja come out and confidently deal with that. Quick to release then, looking for the pace and ability of Kazimoto. 25 minutes gone by, we haven't seen the card as yet in this match. Has been fairly clean, although it has been played with a lot of commitment and a great pace.
Yeah, you must say that that the commitment is there, especially from URA today. There you can see a team that doesn't want to take any prisoners and wants to win the game, because a good start will normally build the confidence. And if URA beats a team like Simba, they'll feel that they can go all the way and win it, because Simba are the giants of this region and they have the history more than URA has.
Clears up then. The line was held exceptionally well then by the Simba defense. They pushed up almost in unison.
Yeah, Robert Sentongo, the danger man of URA, must be watched. And Simba playing the high line, they've got to be very careful, because he is quick as well and he shoots with 2 feet and can hit the ball as well, Robert Sentongo.
Foul on Felix Sunzu.
Not seen much of him since the shot in the earlier exchanges. He's been closed out pretty well by the URA defense, particularly Derek Waludia and Samuel Sinkum. I just get a feeling that his center midfield needs to create more for him. They've not done that, especially looking to the center midfield where you have Ramadan and Musamuddin. They need to try and feed him with more balls so that he can have a sniff at goal, at least, I guess.
Well, the sniff may be coming up now. The midfield once again crowded, and the man to come out of that tussle with the ball at his feet, Owen Gasule. He has impressed here in his first official game for URA. Long ball forwards. Is the defense taking absolutely no chances? Safety first, the order of the day for Juma Nyoso.
Yeah, Tanzanian international. He's been around for some time now, and he's a seasoned campaigner for Simba and the Tanzanian national team. Quite an experienced player.
Been with Simba for 4 seasons, former Ashanti United man. Oh, some impressive touches coming in the central areas. In the end, a desperate challenge sees Simba win it back then.
Oh, and that's the defender, Derek Waludia, playing for. You ask yourself a question, what is he doing there?
Well, he was riding the wave. URA unable then to find the eye of the needle. Now, this is Mude Musa. Mafta, engine challenge then, ill-timed. The referees allow play to continue, wondering if he'll bring it back. Looks like it won't be the case here. URA under pressure defensively, able to impressively bring the ball forwards. Pass off to past. Gasule heavily involved right from the opening stages of this match.
That was a good play from Gasule, you know, holding the ball up well and distributing it as well. And he's doing a good job so far. Just needs not to avoid being clumsy, especially when he's in a dangerous position near his penalty area, like he did a few minutes ago.
A strong challenge coming in then, and they're certainly not holding anything back with their challenges. Bit of space out on the far side, and a run from deep being made by Ali Fini. Nyoso. Nice little turn. Sunzu had strayed into an offside position. So if that ball had found him, the whistle would have surely gone. There is a man down outside the centre circle on the near side. Looks like it may be Kasule then. As he was looking as though he was getting up, his teammates had put the ball out for the throw-in.
Yeah. We didn't see what happened. It must have been an off-the-ball incident. But he's holding his ankle. Could have been kicked while he was passing the ball. It would be very bad for URA if they lost him now. You hope that it's not as bad as he seems to be grimacing right now. You can see the Simba fans still in voice and still hopeful that their team can bounce back from this one. Not going to be bothered by the the critics on the other end of the field, that is younger fans. And the fact that the younger fans are supporting URA, that is not going to set them off. They're going to keep in voice and push on their team.
Well, the positive thing here, if Simba fans are looking for them, as we look at the challenges coming in here, there have been some really strong challenges. Owen Kasule involved, then one of his teammates may have been the reason why he is now limping off the field. But the positive thing here for Simba fans, if they are looking for any positivity, that goal came early enough for them to have plenty of time to look for the equalizer, rather than in the match yesterday with the younger games, or younger goals rather, came rather late in that match, the second really. The tying moments of that match, just put in the final nail.
They still have time to recover as a team, if they put their acts together.
Plenty of time to turn things around here. 30 minutes have gone by in this match, and while we came into it hoping for good football, we hope you at home have enjoyed the football that is being dished out on the field, brought to you by the World of Champions.
Only Super Sport is where you can catch this game.
Game seems to have quieted down just a bit over the last few minutes.
And with the heat, they've got to step on it a bit to slow it down, because if you're going to play 90 minutes, it's still a long way to go, so they can't overexert themselves as players.
Set piece here for URA. Chance maybe for the early delivery, quite some way out. Tunyon Massa, the man standing over it.
Cranes International, since 2003, season campaigner.
So on the Kafa Kagame Cup in 2005 with Villa, will be looking for the assist here in the opening match for URA. Decent delivery, and they needed someone attacking it on the far post. In the end, it'll end well here for URA. They'll have the ball at their feet. Fortunately, they will have plenty of men back defending for Simba. The early ball and a bit of indecisiveness defensively then from Simba.
That is something that we've been talking about. Their defense has not looked as sharp as you'd have expected them to look.
Kasule, and who's won the league twice in Uganda with two different clubs.
Yeah, he's one of those great entertainers, and he's now an international player. And you think that this being an international tournament, it is an opportunity for him to show his class.
Kazimoto looking to show his class in helping Simba claw their way back into this match.
Yeah, so far he has been closed down so well by Munaba Allan, and he's always forced to backtrack and take that turn back and look from the side of his teammates instead of going forward. So you must credit Munaba Allan for the way he's contained him.
Nice little touch then. URA looking for the gap in between the two defenders then. It was there to be exploited, but there was a little bit of contact, body contact, especially on Robertson Togo, that saw him slow down and unable to get there when the ball got through. Otherwise, good play and approach play from the side from Uganda. Now, Sunzu is big, strong, not strong enough. Work defensively out on that far side, although Sunzu is still not giving up on that chase. Calm work defensively, impressive, even some of the